Okay, here's another scenario, my children. Let's say Brother Dwayne's grandmother dies. Heaven forbid. But she leaves Dwayne with a sizable inheritance. We all know coveting wealth and possessions is not an acceptable path to enlightenment. But we shall not also refuse gifts from those we love and those who love us. Now, if Dwayne, seeing that this endowment is entrusted to him, decides to keep this inheritance for himself, is this right on or not right on? Anyone?
That's not right on, Dwayne. How could you?
Cosmo, please. This is a hypothetical situation.
But seriously, Dwayne?
Come on, Dwayne.
Come on, man.
Now, what did I just say, Gemini? Is anyone listening? Again, Dwayne is okay here. This did not happen. But, Dwayne, what would you do?
I'd share it with the group, of course.
Ah, Dwayne, your answer is right on. And, Dwayne, your grandmother is dead. All right, let's try another one, shall we? We all know that Firefly and Ruby Rainbow are in love. Bliss through this lifetime, the next, and through all eternity. But let's say that I'm interested in sleeping with Ruby Rainbow after our little meeting. Is this right on?
Definitely not right on.
Ah, Firefly. I can see why you'd guess that. Not now, my child. I'm in the middle of something. What the fuck is that?
I think it's a letter.
Please edit my will so that when I die, or if I die, that a mariachi band will play Celito Lindo at the site of my passing. You know. Anyway, my mother was a diminutive woman.
Sure, I can do all this for you. Willie, is that why you're here today?
I don't understand this shit.
Look. Okay, Willie, this is some pretty serious stuff.
You know I don't believe in taxes.
Well, it looks like they believe in you.
That's what it says.
Have you read the letter?
I skimmed it.
It's three paragraphs, Willie.
Alisa Tiger Lily.
That's not my name. Anymore.
You know, I'm sensing a real attitude here. I still don't know why you left us, Freddy. And in the middle of the night, too. A coward's exit.
You can't do that in here.
Okay, why don't you tell me the things I can do in here? Seems like there's a lot of bogus rules in this shitty little office. Can't call people by the cool names I gave them. You can't light a spleef. I mean, can I even breathe the air in here? Look at you sitting behind the desk, probably wearing pants. I bet you wear pants every day, don't you?
Yeah, I wear pants, Willie. And you want to know why I wear pants? Because it got a little weird when you started referring to yourself as his almighty cosmic ruler.
I use those words figuratively. We're all God. I'm God. This lamp's God. You're God.
You do not believe for a second that I am God. You can't even say that with a straight face.
Tiger Lily, of the two of us in this room right now, which one of us is God? But if you want to be God, then you can be God.
You're broke. You've been trespassing on land for nearly a decade and a half. You need serious help, or you need to start throwing some money at this thing.
So help me. What about some lawyer mumbo-jumbo?
Why would I do that?
Because you're one of my cosmic children. What about album royalties?
Royalties. You pressed 100 records, and you forced my parents' hand to buy up a crate.
You're talking about certified gold.
That you spray-painted gold.
I'm sensing there's some tension in our friendship. Might I send you a touch assist?
I tend not to make friends with people who brainwash me.
You know, I don't like that term, Tiger Lily. It hurts my feelings.
I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll make some calls over at City Hall. Maybe they could get you a break on squatter's rights or something.
Ah, you're a sage, my child.
Oh, I am not doing this for you. I'm doing it for my friends back at the compound. When you go down to City Hall, wear something decent. You're going to ask for a Jorgensen.
Jorgensen? Please, that's a made-up name.
Says the man who made up a religion.
Yeah? Well, light and love to you too, motherfucker.
Follow me this way. You can crash anywhere you like, man.
Do you have anything in a linen?
Dwayne, you still bummed about your dead grandma?
Yeah, Willie says our body's just the best.
Hey, man. I know just the thing. Try Willie Berry Blinker.
Cilantro wreaks havoc on Willie's sensitive stomach.
It's parsley.
Since you won the last one, Trinity, you break.
No, I want you to have a chance to get ahead.
It's very diplomatic of you. Are you Libra by any chance?
No, I'm a Jew.
Is this an in-house rock combo? Lots of different kinds of bongos, or?
This is Father Willie's Cosmic Children. Concept album about a fool's first step.
Full album. Probably why I've never heard of them.
Ah, but you're hearing them now. Willie wired this whole place. He was a French scientist in a previous life.
I thought that was all right.
Oh, you guys rushed my tom-tom solo.
All right, so I'm talking like a guitar player.
I think that's a take.
Brothers and sisters, I'd like you to meet Brother Benson.
Nice tie, man. This is Mal and Chibo, Captain Manchego, Xanadu, Crimson Moon, Hickory Moon, Deep Dish, she's from Chicago, Genesis, other Crimson Moon, Bongo Girl.
I'm Sunshine.
And Little Lee's working the mix.
What's up, Brother Benny?
Sunshine, Little Lee. Rest of the group.
Oh, I almost forgot. Your energy beads.
What am I, a hula girl?
They enhance your aura.
Willie's home!
Willie's home!
Willie!
Come on, let's go meet our father.
your meeting with Tiger Lily go? Is he coming back to us?
I'm so grateful to the kind soul that sent correspondence to his whereabouts. I could imagine him rejoining us soon. You know, I dug this child from a ditch, his mind ravaged, and his face completely covered in shit.
Why did he leave in the first place?
Leave? Why, he would never leave us. He was, kidnapped. That's what it was, kidnapped.
Father Willie, are we in danger?
Oh, no. That threat's long gone. I kicked the tar out of Tiger Lily's captors. Now, remember, I was a judo master in a previous life.
And a French scientist.
You're so powerful, Father Willie.
You bet your ass, Xanadu. Now, if you'll all excuse me, I've got to get back to my chambers for a reflective, meditative session.
Good night. Good night,
Father Willie.
Love you.
You listen to me, fuck. You listen to me, fuckface. Look here, fuckface. Now, you listen to me, fuckface. Listen here, fuckhead. Dear fuckhead, okay? God damn it. All right, let me get myself together. How do I look?
Like a slave.
Perfect. May I have this dance?
Hi there. Are you Mr. Willie?
You know, they should have had Peter have more songs on their records. He's the one with the chops. All right, Jorgensen, let's get this over with. Stop yanking my chain, you little ween. All right, now you listen here, fuckface. I won this land fair and square. Years ago, in an arm wrestling contest, way back when you were just still sucking on your mommy's tits. I'm not gonna let some pencil-pushing, Ivy League little prick push me and my children back out.
Mr. Willie, please. I've simply been sent here by my superior to ask if you'd like a refreshment while you wait.
Why the hell didn't you say so? I love a hot cocoa.
Good morning. I appreciate your visit, but I don't know how Mr. Blackwood is expecting I can help your situation. I'm Holly Jorgensen, by the way. It's a pleasure.
You're Jorgensen?
That's what I said, isn't it? What can I do for you?
I had this whole speech plan, but no, it just doesn't feel right.
Listen, you fuckface.
I couldn't say it to your face, you know, now with you being abroad and all.
No need to be sexist.
Hey, sexist? Me? I got 31 wives. I'm a card-carrying feminist, honey.
Mr. Allen, we have a severe matter on our hands.
It's Father Willie.
Excuse me?
My name's Father Willie. It's my chosen name, my destiny.
I will address you as the state of Massachusetts legally recognizes you, William Wilson Allen.
You know, names are only an accepted reality, but whatever gets you to sleep at night, sister.
Let's begin then. For starters, we're looking at a seizure of land deeds, any vehicles, and any other assets. That's just at a state level. The implications of a federal investigation, which I cannot speak to officially, are rather grim. I feel I should warn you, you're looking at criminal charges.
But what about religious exemptions or squatters' rights? I've heard of those.
Listen, I remember reading an article about your little cult a few years ago.
Let's not use the C word, please.
Have you ever told yourself a lie so many times that you've started to believe it?
Lies? I'm helping these people. They need me.
In movies, do you notice how ghosts are always wearing a tweed suit with a watch chain or an Edwardian cloak? Maybe a fancy ball gown with pearls?
Where are you going with this? The last movie I saw was The Computer Wore Tennis Shoes.
This idea only works if anyone who ever lived died at a fancy dinner party. Why don't we ever see a ghost wearing boxer shorts, holding the remote control, or covered in a bloody hospital gown?
Ooh, gross.
We always want to remember the past in a romantic light, though it may be a lie. I think you've been telling yourself a lie for so long that you've wound up believing it. It's a fantasy, but life is sad and life is unfair, and on that note, let's get back to the matter at hand.
Just a second. In this little play you're talking about, am I the stylish ghost, or am I the ghost in his underwear?
Bottom line, you've been lying and stealing from people, and lying and stealing from the United States government. People may forgive, the government will not forget. I'm going to go through this line by line. $9,289.74, Massachusetts Electric Company, willing to negotiate to $5,000 pending investigation. $4,898.22, Massachusetts state back taxes. Charges include penalties for 10-year period.
Thank you. Honolulu to Helsinki, from Pasadena to Plymouth Rock, hula girl waving at the airport. Willie says, I'll see you around the block. A sleeper car leaving Strasbourg, a lab coat hanging from a hook, razor flying out the window. Father thinks it's time for a new look. Willie, oh Willie, he could guide you to a higher plane. Willie, oh Father Willie, if you know Willie, I don't have to explain. His robe could wrap around the planet. He makes things great when they seem grim. He shines his light on all his children, and in return we shine it back on him. Willie, oh won't he? If you know Willie, then you know we will. Willie, oh won't he? If you know Willie, then you know he will. If you've met Father, then you know he will.
The crowd goes wild.
Go to bed.
Where are you going, my father?
Yeah.
simple.